Hi, Dave Fogler here, reporting in from the San Francisco studio, but I just returned a couple days ago from my second stint in the wilds of northern Maine, where, even though the vast majority of my experience is pretend build experience in visual effects for film, I have been tackling a very not pretend major restoration of a 140-year-old lakeside cabin, largely by myself. I'm here to get you up to speed for the following film, which covers the last 6 months of work. So know that this property was built by my wife Mary's great-great-grandparents sometime in the late 1880s. It is an absolute gem, but it's in need of significant period restoration work. I don't think that camera's working. You can find episodes and or a compilation of year one on the Cinedrome channel page. You should also know that this season began a little problematically with carpal tunnel release surgery on both hands, but on April 7th, I packed off from San Francisco to Maine for my second summer of figuring out how to do all this.
ID, license, or passport?
My general assembly is voted by a...
He broke his finger trying to prove the Cybertruck won't break your fingers.
Thank you. down at the lake end of this operation, this is the stop check valve. It prevents water from flowing out of the system, only allows water to flow in. And it looks to be in great shape.
Two big days are coming up. I have excavation equipment being delivered, and I will be doing what I hope is the last of the big, ambitious excavation under the camp.
I'm replacing the old rickety post and beam foundation. And while I'm at it, I'm making the job harder by adding usable space.
The space is 30 feet by 15 feet. Last summer, I put up more than half of the concrete posts and beams. Well, maybe half. But I only removed a portion of the soil. Excavating the rest of this in one go will be a bit of a tile puzzle. I'll strategically put up a house jack, excavate an area, move the house jack into that area, move on. Now, the high drama, which may not be readily apparent, is that 3 days from now, I will either have a fully excavated space ready to finish, or we will be looking at a big or several big pieces of ledge, which will stop things dead in their tracks. How do you spell conveniently? Camera died at the climactic moment. I hooked it on the top corner, pulled it, and it collapsed under the sewer line without hitting it. It was great. Now I've got to get it out of here. Thank you.
this large, very interesting looking formation, which is very much in the room. And I would leave it, but I fear that having this permeate the back concrete wall would lead to water seeping into the space forever. And this stone, I don't know, my stone is breakable. We have another day of digging ahead. Feels good to get this one in. I'm working my way around to get that one out, and it's doing a lot of work. There we go.
The ledge spirits were remarkably kind. Magic footing ledge comes up into the floor. That's all right. Stadium seating rocks will go or stay. And we got this big boulder, which I kind of like. So we finish out the board form concrete walls, put in the rest of the cedar posts, the rest of the hemlock beams. The open spaces are filled with rough cut white pine framing, a concrete slab, then my father's billiard table, a piano, big double door looking out at the lake, window, 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 and a bar right back here. Long bench running along that side of the room. Almost done. This is a little embarrassing. Very much not like me. I've been racing around from project to project over the last 6 weeks. And I have really let this place fall apart. a tent, clearly, on a 20 by 30 foot platform. And I put it all together last summer to act as a temporary shop staging storage area and be the hub of restoration work wherever work may be happening on the property. I started sorting my workspaces yesterday with something resembling a proper edit suite and humble camera department. And so, as much as I would love to have the bandwidth to start building a final shop and studio, this is what I've got, and I shouldn't be complaining about anything. So let's get this up and running. Is hot. And these crazy windows, they're an oddity in the camp. They must have been salvaged from something like a school or a library. And all of their screens have fallen off, and they need to be open. Still hot. All of this is lumber that I've pulled from the camp. So it's I don't know if it's historically significant lumber. It's historically significant to the camp. And I certainly want to save it so that I have old lumber to use when I need it to match. I don't have a great place to store it. I'm going to try putting it under this platform for now. And it's going to be hot again today, but it is early in the morning, still relatively cool. So now is the time. This is the kind of place that has been puttered on and maintained by generations of people storing fasteners in old Skippy jars. Is a vast improvement on the general state of things. And I'm now thinking that if I did nothing more than build a 4x8 rolling shop table, ILM model shop style, that could be in the middle of the room, function as a feed table for this wee little table saw, then I would probably find myself up here working on projects more often. So, I'm going to go soak my head in the lake. Maybe it's only been 2 weeks, but they have been filled with many, many relatively small tasks, all geared toward getting this place ready for guests who at this point arrive tomorrow, including sorting bedding and mattresses for our 12, 13 old beds. Oh, I wired up the now three lights in the stairway and landing on a three-way switch circuit, so they can be turned on and off at the top and bottom of the stairs. And I am no electrician, but as a wise friend is fond of saying, time can compensate for lack of experience. And this probably took me 2 days. How we access the water is still very much a work in progress. It's proving to be a little tricky to figure out. I know from photos that back in the day, way back in the day, there was a set of stairs here. And thinking they might have known what they were up to, I cobbled this set together from bits and pieces of salvaged old stairs. I used the rock that came out from under the sewer line as a first step. But with folks on the way, it is high time to get the dock in.
Perfect. In the 70s, a road was put in and a great big parking area. We've decided to keep a small access road down to the camp, but want to reduce all this so that the view out the west side of the camp is more forest-like. So I've been mapping out how small this road can be and finding where we can start planting trees. And it's starting to rain. And here's the first tree I've transplanted, a little hemlock. Thank you.
This week's little story is about what it's like to restore an old camp on a lake in Maine and do it in a relatively small, relatively remote town filled with family and friends of family, most of whom have parents and grandparents and sometimes great-great-great-great-great-grandparents who spent time on the porch of your old camp. Let's say that this camp was built sometime in the 1880s, and every stick of lumber in it is this beautiful, rough-cut, true-dimensioned timber featuring planks, some of which are 19 inches. There's one over there that must be 24. And let's say that in 2024, you would like to know what this lumber is and if it's remotely possible to find something like it. What you would do is go get coffee. You'll want to get your coffee in town. And because we're not in San Francisco at the moment, you'll be able to pull up and park right outside the county co-op. It's a great place. I actually built a window display for them a while back. Most mornings, there's a group of fine people who sit at this table right here. And what is the lumber in my camp? It's white pine, and as it ages, it turns orange, and around here, we call it pumpkin pine. And where can I get some? Well, Caleb Hopkins has taken over the old Hopkins family mill out in Hodgdon. Good guy, you should go talk to him.
You're gonna be a movie star.
Hello, Caleb.
What's up, Dave?
Thank you.
And then we're going to keep the stripping.
Close it out.
After a year and a half of kicking this saloon project around, it is wildly satisfying to have a corner fully resolved. Granted, it's a small little section. What it really is a material sampler, and I'm happy to say that I love the material. I don't know how long it takes white pine to turn as orange as the 140-year-old white pine elsewhere in this place, but it's already more yellow than it was when it was milled 6 months ago. It's a little less satisfying to look in this direction, but progress is being made over here as well. All of the footings are now poured, and the next step is to frame up and pour the big high concrete wall in the back. But this weekend we have guests, and it is time to get out on the water. This week, I am returning my attention to the foundation work under the camp and in the saloon. While we're working in the saloon, let's have a ledge update. You remember this tower of stone that's over here in the corner? I've been beating on it with a sledgehammer for a couple days, and I've reduced it down to this single stone. I still have to heave-ho all these big chunks out of here. Now that I'm looking at this really quite beautiful chunk of granite, it turns out it's granite, I think I have a plan. We're behind the bar right here. Bar's right here. You're making coffee, you're making drinks. Having a sink would be a plus. Sink has to be higher than the sewer line. So I'm starting to imagine pouring essentially the concrete footing on top of this stone, and then you've got an elevated area. Sink can go right here. If it's here, we're above the sewer line, we can plumb it. It'll work. Will water seep in underneath or around this stone I'm leaving in the back corner? Maybe. This big chunk of ledge has been here for a year, and there's no moisture weeping in around it, so let's choose to be optimistic and keep this in here, because it'll look pretty great. That's the plan. Forging on.
Start pulling it from the bottom. It's
intention that it'll have, you'll have a larger overhang than stools.
Hello, I'm here, chalk in hand, to tell you that it is September 10th, which means I have not cut together an update for five weeks. I can explain what happened. The ratio of labor between the designing and building and the filmmaking is really about 1:1. Now, I love the designing and building, and I love the filmmaking, so the time demands of either one is not a problem until available time becomes limited. When that happens, the designing and building tends to win out. And about 2 weeks ago, I suddenly only had about 20 days left here at the camp with a long list of things to wrap up before winter. The filmmaking has taken a hit. In a bit of backwards storytelling, let's start with a tour of everything I've gotten done to date. I had a track loader here for a couple days, and I cleared off all the organic matter off the top of the old tennis court, and the two big piles of gravel I moved all the way down to the job site. A lot of that gravel I put down onto the small access road we're maintaining down to the camp, and I reworked the topology around here really quite a bit to help with water runoff. I planted 3 or 4 trees, probably about 20 to go in this area. I insulated and waterproofed and backfilled behind the big concrete wall at the back of the saloon. And with more of that gravel, I finished the French drain that runs back here. And I framed and closed in the upper wall. I installed this cross beam and put in this white pine wall. I had to reroute a lot of electrical, and I boiled it down to this single packet, which I'm snaking through the wall here to be dealt with by a proper electrician someday. And I sistered a 4x8 up against that 8x8 to make this beam stronger. It's carrying a heavy load. I installed this beam, this post, and I'm starting to close in these walls. I poured the first section of floor, partly to figure out how to do it. It's 4 inches of gravel, sand to smooth it out, 2 inches of insulation, and 4 inches of concrete. I poured this retaining wall for the storage space, and I put in 2 footings for posts, all of which are pinned into ledge and frost safe. I'm about to put in this beam, which I believe gets us up to date. So let's wind back 5 weeks to the beginning of this story. There's been a change in the seasons. Not only is fall coming on fast, there's the first I've seen of leaves changing color. But things have also quieted down on the lake, and I now have my days to myself to work on this operation. And some things are moving forward nicely. The last of the saloon concrete walls has been poured. And with another quiet day to myself, let's pull these forms and see how she looks. Chipmunk.
Thank you. turn.
Come on.
Welcome back to September 10th. Welcome back to
October
10th. That was the moment that the build side of this operation took over from the filmmaking side and I stopped shooting. But while we're here and before the end of the day, let's put in this beam. The filmmaker can't keep up with the builder. It's October 11th, and I snuck in this little wall and window project. This is the end. I promise.